think I've got everything.
G'day guys, how you going? Just going over to get some oysters from a little local creek near my place. Hopefully I'm not shaking this thing around too much. But yeah, I was feeling some oysters, so I'm gonna go collect some. I'll cook up some oysters Kilpatrick tonight. Stay tuned for some good trout fishing out west. We're going out the back of Lake Lyle very soon. In a couple of weeks actually, October long weekend. So a little run around, we'll grab some oysters. And I'll see you soon. Hope you enjoy it. No rush, trying to finish my coffee as well. Glassy morning out here, but it's meant to be a pretty horrible day. Go see if we can find some oysters, eh? Trying not to get super muddy and wet. All right, we're away. If I had more time, I would have brought a rod with me. Just to have a flick. So much mud on everything after those floods. But I'm getting real wet. The tide's coming in so fast, so I'll make this a quick one. There's just still silt and mud everywhere after those floods. I won't be taking too many oysters anyway, so we'll grab a couple and cook them up, make something yummy. So these aren't really the oysters that I was coming out to get. The tide's just hammering in and I don't have enough time to fight against the tide all morning. We'll take a few. Oh. That's little baby mussels. So I know someone's going to have a whinge at me about grabbing the rocks with the oysters on, but just relax. I come past here every day to go to work twice a day. And this is one of those spots where I have a little bit of a, not a weird like obsession with, but I spend a lot of time out along this little stretch of river. And as some of my viewers know and some of my mates in town, I am constantly picking up rubbish from a little spot up there. It looks like it's full of rubbish again. If I have a little clip on my phone of the other day when I was out here, I'll put that in there as well, but I don't think I do, so I think I deleted it just because I was sick of it. But we'll load these up, and don't you worry, all these rocks will be going back on the side of the river. I'll probably put them up there where there's a bit of a washout, so do not stress about that. Cool, I got that done just before it started raining again. That was good. Bloody kayak always wears me out. See if I can get out of here. Stop at my little spot that I come and chill out sometimes just to do a bit of a clean up. as I said, if I've got that little clip on my phone, I'll still put it in there. It's actually not as bad today as what it normally is. When I was out here the other day, it was just constantly picking up people's bloody KFC rubbish and just crap everywhere. So I've got a mate that lives up on the hill out there, so we both keep an eye out if you guys do see this. We will catch you one day. And if it's that guy with that dodgy looking SS, I'm just going to push you into the river with the bull bar. So your choice. Keep littering here if that's you, mate. If not, then just enjoy and don't take that personally. It's actually pretty clean compared to normal. God, it's got an old Esky and Tupperware, a couple of bloody Coke cans, and like a dash mat or something. I don't even know what that is. But you can see people fish here and camp here. Just keep it clean, guys. Like, if I do have that footage, I'll put it up here and you'll just see how grubby it gets during the week. I've stopped here 2 days in a row before and filled up bags. Most time I'm here, I take rubbish. And at least take your durry butts with you. Jesus. Beautiful little spot. There's no point spoiling it. All right, let's get out of here before I get too wet. Now, I'll show you what you should do with your rubbish. Rubbish. Pretty easy. Ute, not that hard. I'm sure you've all got bins at home. If you don't, there's plenty of bins around. And no one's gonna care if you're putting rubbish in a bloody bin. Look at the spot we're in and people just leave crap everywhere. So, add my little whinge down. Get back and sort out these oysters. So I've just given them a quick wash off to get all that gross flood mud off them. But I'm gonna have to deal with these a little bit later because I'm taking the kiddos swimming. And I really want my kids to be able to swim like little fishes. So I'll bang them in the fridge for now. And we'll have a crack at these later and get some oysters Kilpatrick going. That is a solid oyster. Some good ones there.
Oh. So this is just what I've sorted out so far. All those rocks, as I said, they're going back. I've got a bunch of little mussels as well, which I don't want to waste, and I love mussels, so I'll shuck those in a minute. There's still a bunch on there, but there's, you know, they're still alive, they're still cold, so I'm going to pop them back tomorrow on the way to work. Ah, look at the size of these weapons. Nice. Don't have to be rich to eat rich. All right, so those rocks, there's still a couple of oysters on those. And I'm just going to dump them back in the water tomorrow, so I'll keep them alive and put them back in where there's a bit of a washout. That's what I got. And oysters Kilpatrick, look at the size of them. I know there's probably 24 there maybe. Also a couple of little mussels that I'll make a bit of a dish out of, but pretty keen on dinner tonight. Yes, darling. Hi. All right, so there's all my oysters all cleaned up. I don't even know how many are there, but there are some solid ones. If you can see my fat hands. Kilpatrick coming up. There's a bunch of little mussels there as well, so I don't throw mussels back pretty much ever. I love them. Whatever was left on the rocks will be going back in tomorrow morning on the way to work. And they'll still be alive, no dramas at all. But Kilpatrick for dinner tonight, hell yeah, pretty keen on that. Say hi, kids.
Hi.
Teddy.
Say hi. Hi.
Hi. Hello.
Hi.
Keep eating dinner.
What are you doing?
Alright, so kids are finally in bed after a bloody long day. And the missus has gone out to dinner, so she won't be having any Kilpatrick. So I've got 24 oysters to myself for dinner. So probably won't eat all of them tonight. I'm going to make them up just typical oysters Kilpatrick tonight, and I'm going to save the big ones tomorrow for a different, I don't know, I'll get a bit inventive with these, but look at the size of them. Solid oysters there. Some big ones. But these ones are just going to be typical Worcestershire cheese, bacon, nothing too fancy. Yeah, should be a good feed there. So I'm going to start this out with just a little dab of Worcestershire. It's a bit spicier than what I thought, so a little dab on that one, dab on that one. Get some bacon going on there. Nothing too fancy. I want to make sure they're covered in bacon because I'm not a massive fan of oysters. But oysters Kilpatrick are pretty bloody good. Yeah. And of course, anything left in that baking pan, I will be eating. Delicious. Oh, grate some cheese for them. So this is actually the, so this is actually the first time I've ever done oysters Kilpatrick. If I'm ever getting oysters, normally it's just for my mum, so she can have fresh and stuff. The missus hates oysters. I certainly don't like fresh oysters. But oysters Kilpatrick, I do like. Anything covered in cheese and bacon, it's always pretty good.
I'm just going to put a bit more Worcestershire on there. Not too much. It's a bit spicy. Well, for me, it's a bit spicy. For most people, it's just probably normal. But I don't handle heat very well. So, looking pretty yummy. There's a dozen there. Should be a good feed. And I've got another, I think there's 11 huge ones in there. So these are only the small ones. The big ones will come tomorrow night. And we'll bang them in the oven, see what happens.
Cool. I ain't no chef by any means, but
figure about 180. Cheese will melt. Bacon's already cooked. And for me, I just want to take some of the sliminess out of the oysters. I'm not real keen on that sort of stuff, but see what happens. I'll let you know. You can watch me eat them. If I start wigging out and dry reaching, you know, they're not great. Cheese tastes good. Wish you tastes good. We'll see what happens with them. I've got to go wrestle the kids into bed now. I've got Teddy down, but Ella's still halfway down. Let's see what's going on, eh? Oh, they're looking pretty good.
Not bad. So these are my first oysters, Kilpatrick. Just standard Worcestershire, a heap of bacon, a heap of cheese, and a dozen oysters from South Coast. Collected by myself. These are the smallest out of the nearly two dozen. I think there's 10 left or something. But they're all the big ones. We'll play with them tomorrow night and do something a bit different. But I'm keen. I can hear bloody Ella calling out. So I'll let them cool down for a second. And I'm going to tuck in.
Yeah, so I couldn't help myself. I've got some oyster sauce. For my oysters. Better put a light on. Oh, it's a fan. That's a wrong light. I'll work it out eventually. Shows you how much I try to film in light. The bloody lights in this house. There we go. You'd think I know where my own light switch is, being that I've lived here for like, I don't know, at least 4 years. But we got some oyster sauce. Got a dozen oyster Kilpatrick. See how these go, eh?
I just had my first one, and seriously, these are like restaurant quality. Little dab of the oyster sauce on top gives it like a little bit of a sweetness. I'm gonna be getting a lot more oysters. These are epic. God damn, that's good. So if I was a chef, yeah, I might have overcooked them or whatever. But you probably just saw me drool then. That's how good they are. Oh damn. It's so good. Turns out I'm going to be smashing oysters Kilpatrick all the time. Because this is epic. Don't miss that bit of bacon.
Seriously, I didn't want to keep drooling in front of the camera. And most people know I don't really like oysters. I'm on my roots anyway, but that's three oysters. And one bit. I wonder if I can get that off. Look at that. I'm gonna be eating oysters all the time. As I said, I ain't no chef. I've had oysters at like Kilpatrick at restaurants, fancy ones. That nearly tops them, I reckon. So good. Possibly because I overload it with bacon and cheese and oyster sauce and stuff, but I will be eating these again. God damn, that's good. Oyster sauce. My theory was it wouldn't be called oyster sauce unless it was meant to go on oysters. And it makes it a little bit more sweeter. Damn, that's good. That's so good. I did not a bad job shucking them either, like. On that one, it was the first little crunch I had. And, I felt like sand wasn't a shell or anything, so. I can deal with that. God damn, that's good. Last one of the dozen. I never quite got oysters as a bloody aphrodisiac or whatever. I understand it now. I'm in love with oysters, Kilpatrick. This is flash as. Gonna crap all over the lounge, but god damn, that was yummy. So I've washed my hands, guys, but that was an epic feed. I really wish I did the whole lot. I thought I was going to get like full after 12 or whatever. God damn, that was good. No, I won't. I'll cook the rest tomorrow. Get a little bit of oyster sauce on top of your Kilpatrick. That's amazing. It's probably why it's called oyster sauce. Yum, yum. Alright, so thanks for watching, guys. Turns out I am like a master oyster cooker. Because that was like, there's not a bad taste at all in my gob. Like, and I'm normally not a fan of oysters. I don't mind oysters, Kilpatrick, at all. But that just like, that's a new game. I'm keen as a bean on that. That was delicious, so. I don't know, I might film it tomorrow when I'm experimenting with different flavors and hoisin sauce and all that, but that, I can't even think of anything that was bad about that, and I'm normally pretty critical of my cooking. That was on point. So you'll probably see me in a few more oysters. not fresh because they're gross, but Kilpatrick, heaps of bacon, heaps of cheese, Worcestershire, a little bit of the old oyster sauce to just dab on top, sweeten it up a bit. Goddamn, that was good. So, please like and subscribe, all the rest of it. If you could, that'd be awesome. Give it a share or, you know, all the general jargon everyone says. But, catch you soon. Hope you've enjoyed. And if you're not a fan of oysters, give the Kilpatrick a go. That was awesome. And I'm going to smash those big ones tomorrow night. Probably exactly the same as that. And I'm going to force the missus to have one because that was on point. Keen as a bean. Thanks for watching, guys. Talk soon. Cheers.